Asia Bibi, the Catholic woman set free by a Pakistani court on blasphemy charges, says she still fears for her life. The country's Supreme Court is weighing a petition from Islamic extremists who want her executed. According to a new report, she's not the only one. The persecution of Christians is on the rise around the world. Correspondent Wyatt Goolsby has details from the State Department. Good evening, Wyatt.
Good evening, Lauren. The State Department is well aware of Bibi's case, and officials say religious freedom is a key foreign policy priority for the Trump administration. Many Americans hope that's true. The Christian advocacy group Open Doors USA says 30 million more Christians experienced persecution compared to last year. Many of them are worried they'll be forgotten.
This Christian woman tells me she lives a life of fear. Hannah is wearing a burqa because she doesn't want anyone to see her face or know her real name and country. She's from South Asia, where blasphemy laws could result in her going to jail or even death.
Imagine walking down a corridor and the walls around you beginning to come in on you, and the path that you're walking on constantly shifting, constantly changing. And that's the life of a secret believer. That's the life of a Christian.
Hannah is a teacher, but she says she can't teach what is good and true. She's forced to use biased textbooks, which paint non-Muslims as second-class citizens.
From the very earliest days of their exposure to studies, to academics, to learning, they are already being reminded, if they're Christian, they're being reminded that there's no place for you here.
Christians around the world are facing the same persecution, according to Open Doors USA. Their annual watch list identifies the worst violators of religious freedom. North Korea is number one again, but so are many countries in Asia, Africa, and the Middle East. David Curry is the group's president.
Essentially, what we see is more governments using laws and their police force to control, and in some cases, seeking to eliminate the expression of Christian faith.
Hannah prays that won't happen and asks everyone to do the same.
So pray that the Spirit of God would remind us that we are not forgotten and that we are part of a communion of saints and a cloud of witnesses who is ever glorifying His name.
Another disturbing trend, according to Open Doors, more governments are starting to use technology like facial recognition to spy on Christians. China has asked for cameras to be installed in churches so officials can monitor the people in the pews. Lauren?
Correspondent Wyatt Goolsby reporting from the State Department. Thank you, Wyatt.